Mohs surgery is one of the more exciting developments that has occurred for skin cancer over the last 30, 40 years. In a way, the way I see Mohs, it's like a smart guided missile that precisely targets the cancer while minimizing surrounding damage. I'm Dr. Simon Modorsky. I'm the medical director of Skin Cancer and Reconstructive Surgery Center here in Newport Beach.
Skin Cancer and Reconstructive Surgery Center, or SCARS for short, is a unique multi-specialty practice that manages all aspects of skin cancer. Their collaborative team approach joins dermatologists with plastic surgeons, pathologists, and other skincare professionals to ensure optimal skin cancer treatment. Dr. Modorsky specializes in facial plastic and reconstructive surgery. He is a double board certified physician with over 2 decades of experience. On Mondays, he is in the operating room reconstructing what is known as a Mohs defect, which is the wound left over after a skin cancer is removed.
There's nothing like Mohs surgery because you know with a high degree of certainty that when you're done, that cancer is gone. And because of the nature of skin cancer, it's very unlikely to come back when you're dealing with primary basal cell or low-grade squamous cell carcinoma.
Dr. Goodman is a dermatologist and Mohs surgeon with over 30 years of experience in Mohs surgery alone. He is the founding president of the American Society for Mohs Surgery and is a member of multiple skin cancer foundations in Orange County and throughout California.
By far the most common skin cancer is basal cell carcinoma, and second is squamous cell carcinoma, and there are hundreds of thousands of cases every year in the United States of these two tumors.
Basal cell carcinomas, commonly known as BCCs, mutate from the basal layer of the epidermis, which is the outermost layer of the skin. BCCs often range in appearance depending on their location on the body. On the face, they often present as pink or flesh-colored bumps that may appear as pearly or translucent, or with visible tiny blood vessels. On the body, they tend to appear as red, flat, scaly lesions. Basal cell carcinomas are the most common type of skin cancer. Patients often underestimate them because of their low metastatic potential, meaning they are less likely to spread to other parts of the body. However, if left untreated, they can be aggressive, invasive, and damaging to surrounding structures, including bone. Squamous cell carcinomas, or SCCs, arise from epidermal keratinocytes, also in the outermost layer of the skin. Superficial SCCs typically present as distinct red patches, which can be flat or slightly raised. More invasive squamous cell carcinomas can appear as firm, thickened, raised nodules, or as fleshy soft lesions with areas of ulceration. Squamous cell carcinomas can also spread to other parts of the body, including nerves, blood vessels, and lymph nodes, making them potentially fatal. While metastasis is not common in either basal cell or squamous cell carcinomas, early detection is still important in both skin cancers. Increased awareness with Mohs surgery have made these skin cancers largely curable.
I mean, the published cure rates are 99% to 98% for an agglomeration of basal cells and squamous cell skin cancer. So if we take all of the above, plop them into a barrel, stir them up, that's sort of the cure rate range for primary cancers. Primary meaning it's the first time you have it.
Dr. Miller serves on the board of directors of the American Academy of Dermatology. He is a nationally respected leader in skin cancer and Mohs surgery with almost 4 decades of experience.
How does one get these things? Well, it's a multitude of factors that can conspire against a person. Some out of their individual control and some that are certainly, in retrospect, modifiable.
These factors include skin type, genetic predispositions, immunosuppression, and most importantly, exposure to UV light.
Many sunburns, and especially significant sunburns, will increase the risk for basal cell skin cancer. And that's the overwhelmingly most common skin cancer in the world.
UV rays can break down the structural components of collagen, creating wrinkles. They can even penetrate into our DNA, which can lead to mutations in the basal or squamous cells of the skin. This can lead to an overgrowth of the cells and the development of a skin cancer. Being diagnosed with a skin cancer can be a scary discovery for many, but the multi-specialty approach at Scar Center is a reassuring solution.
Scar Center, or Skin Cancer and Reconstructive Surgery Center, is very different as an entity, as an organization in this area. We bring together multiple specialists under the same roof. From the patient's perspective, the treatment occurs in one setting, in one day. They come in, they get evaluated by Mohs surgeon and get treated with Mohs surgery to remove the cancers. The oncologic surgeon may take additional excisions, whether more significant surgery like lymph node biopsies are necessary. And our plastic surgeons would reconstruct the defect or the hole, all in the same sitting. So it's really a one-stop shop for the patient.
Scar Center also hosts a monthly skin cancer conference for medical professionals. For the last decade, the Scar Center conference has remained the most widely attended meeting for skin cancer professionals in the region. It brings together specialists and thought leaders from multiple disciplines to discuss challenging cases. Cases such as a particularly aggressive skin cancer on a young man's scalp.
Our recent patient had a very complicated basal cell carcinoma history. He's already had multiple skin cancers, and he presented to us for treatment of two simultaneous basal cell carcinomas on his scalp. Now, this is after he's had multiple other cancers, including those on his scalp. At the time of Mohs surgery, Dr. Jewell had discovered that one of the cancers spread subclinically within the skin without any visual signs of it spread. The only way he was able to detect that spread is under the microscope.
Basal cell carcinoma typically grows as one unit, and it doesn't skip, but it can grow irregularly and have little roots that go off in one eccentric direction.
And if a person says, well, it looks like the cancer ends right here, and I'm just going to cut this much around it, and that seems to be okay, and the cancer has just snaked its way a little bit farther, they won't even know it.
This is where the guided missile aspect of Mohs really makes a difference. There is very little room for error. Careful mapping and surgical precision is absolutely essential.